before we actually go into the possession as such, let me share with you my take on Zulawski as an intellectual, as a filmmaker, and as a philosopher. He not only left us with a tremendous amount of great movies that he directed, about 14, I think, all of them, but also a lot of novels. And I am in awe of something which is a blend of diary, critical studies, a novel, and it's very perceptive, and it actually cuts through a lot of personalities. And one of those personalities, an actress, claimed to be badly portrayed in this book, and she managed to actually go to court, and the book is now basically not attainable. But it has extremely rich amount of observations. It's called not sneak, which means not diaries, but nightlies, something that is produced not by the day thinking, but night thinking. But there is also a connotation of chamber pot in Polish language. So it is a wild ride without any barriers hold. He always speaks the truth. There are very, very few real names in this book. Some of them are real only when he really, really esteems somebody. We'll get to that later. Most of the people are referred to only by their initials or by changed names. Anyway, he is ferocious, uncompromising, speaks the truth, and it hurts. It hurts a lot of people. But also this book gives us a window to his thinking. I have a certain theory about filmmakers, Polish filmmakers particularly, or intellectuals, storytellers, and Roman Polański. It's a risky concept, but let me share it with you. I sense a certain distance when Zulawski is talking about Polański. It's like, yes, this guy is brilliant, he is genius, but he's Romek. He's Romek, that's diminutive, and for Roman. And we know more. We maybe read more philosophy books than Romek. And therefore, it gives us this license to sort of look at what he's doing from a little bit from above. That's my assumption. They knew each other quite well, Zulawski and Polański. That's established. Polański was also, because Jerzy Kosiński is not with us. Jerzy Kosiński was a colleague of Polański, so those two guys knew each other quite well. Here we come with personal digression and name dropping. And I will allow myself for this digression simply because in the first episode I shared with you my documentary about my dad, Janusz Kuczyński, Philosopher's Paradise.
It was after the Second War. I had been in underground against Germans at the beginning, after against communists, and fighting with the arms in hands.
Co powodowało, że przeżywałeś?
No, jakieś szczęśliwe zbiegi okoliczności.
No dobrze, a czy to nie jest tak, że każdy człowiek ma jakąś lekcję do przerobienia i w związku z tym żyje tak długo, jak długo to jest potrzebne, żeby taką lekcję zaliczyć?
To, co powiedziałeś, jest bardzo ładne i byłoby dobrze, gdyby było tak rzeczywiście, że człowiek nie umiera, póki nie wykona swojego życiowego zadania. Ale to jest po prostu nieprawda.
I was once in New York, actually after already I decided not to return to Poland, and then sometime later my dad appeared in New York and he stayed with me, and one day there is a phone call and I pick up the phone and it says Jerzy Kosiński, Jerzy Kosiński. I'm thinking, clearly not for me, right? And I sort of, you know, put two and two together, and I said, you are probably wanting to talk to my father. He said, yes, okay. So it turns out that they were actually pals. They were pals in Łódź after the Second World War. And when they met and I was present at this meeting, my father got a book with a note.
To dear Janusz, who so many times saved me from youthful troubles, often missing his own uncertain position versus not easily amused state. Affectionately, Jurek.
And then they went to lunch and I went with them. And at one point, Kosinski mentioned Roman Polański, and he did it in such a way that made it clear that he respects him tremendously. He likes him a lot. But it's Romek. It's not Roman, it's Romek. Well, friends can call each other diminutive. But it was also in the context of being deep enough or not being deep enough. Something like this comes through certain statements of Zulawski, but he also says that Polański is brilliant, well-read, knows Kafka by heart. So we're talking about certain levels.
You're a very nosy fellow, kitty cat, huh? You know what happens to nosy fellows?
And I think that this approach, that the film of a caliber of Chinatown is not deep enough and I can actually outdo it, is what drives Possession by Andrzej Zulawski.